So hi everyone and very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of ARD Current Affairs. And in this session guys, we are going to discuss some of the most important current affairs from the agriculture and rural development section of NABARD grade A examination. And as I told you guys that I have started the ARD Current series and government scheme series. Let me again tell you the timetable: Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Monday, Wednesday and Friday, the sessions are of government schemes, and on Tuesday, there will always be a session on ARD Current Affairs. And I have put only one session for ARD Current Affairs because you guys know that most of the things have been covered through PIB 247 sessions, right? So, jo baki bacha kucha hota hai, we will cover through this ARD Current Affairs, jo ki typically agriculture or rural development se related hoga, right? And for that, one session per week is more than enough. Theek hai, so you guys don't worry. Jitna bhi ARD current affair hoga, whatever be the ARD current affairs which is required for the upcoming NABARD grade examination, that will be covered through these sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys without any delay. But before we begin, if you want to have the all-round preparation of your any government exam, you can download the Anujindal app. And as you all know, we have launched a live course for all the three regulatory bodies exam, RBI, SEBI and NABARD. The live classes for RBI will start from 15th July. SEBI and NABARD already started. And talking about ARD, so Suraj sir is taking classes up to the next level, because ARD ka level unhone bahut acha tarike se wo padha rahe hain, right? So if you want to have the joy of these live classes, you can enroll in these courses. And if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel, the link for which is provided in the description guys. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question from today's session, which says Bureau of Indian Standards has developed an Indian standard for non-electric cooling cabinet made of clay. Okay? It operates on the principle of evaporative cooling. You just have to name that refrigerator, which is nothing but a non-electric cooling cabinet which is made up of clay. And remember, this is not a new refrigerator. It is in news because BIS has developed an Indian standard for it. And what is that Indian standard? That is not important. Indian standard, you will have seen IAS 2001, is tarike se numbers likhe hue hote hai, right? So that number is not important. Just remember, BIS has developed an Indian standard for this non-electric cooling refrigerator which is made up of clay, and you have to identify the name of that refrigerator guys. So the name of the refrigerator is Mitti Cool, right? What is the name? It's Mitti Cool, and it is in news because question wahi humne padh liya that BIS has developed an Indian standard for this refrigerator. Now do remember it, this Mitti Cool refrigerator is a brainchild of Mr. Mansukh Bhai Prajapati, who is from Gujarat. ठीक है, मनसुख भाई प्रजापति हैं गुजरात के, ये उनका ब्रेन चाइल्ड है, उन्होंने ही इसको डेवलप किया था. एंड इट लुक्स लाइक दिस, एंड दिस इज नॉट अ सिंगल डिजाइन, देयर आर वेरियस डिजाइंस एज वेल, राइट? टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस न्यूज, सो रिमेंबर इट ऑपरेट्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इवेपोरेटिव कूलिंग ऑफ कोर्स. ठीक है, अब ये तो कोई टेक्निकल बात है ही नहीं. व्हेन समथिंग इज मेड अप ऑफ क्ले एंड वी आर यूजिंग इट फॉर कूलिंग द सब्सटेंसेस, देन ऑफ कोर्स इट इज वर्किंग ऑन द principle of evaporative cooling, because evaporation leads to leads to cooling, right? And these are the benefits this refrigerator, this Mitti Cool refrigerator is providing. Like for example, it is playing an influential role in reviving the pottery culture, the heritage of Indian culture, right? It is connecting people back to the roots in better, healthier ways, because if you use water from a pot which is made up of clay, then of course that water will be more beneficial for your health, right? It promotes sustainable consumption. Of course, when we are talking about clay, we are of course talking about sustainable consumption. It is economically empowering the indigent community, working towards green and cool earth. Why indigent community? Because of course these clay works are being done by these indigent community only, and this will definitely provide them with the livelihood opportunities and employment opportunities as well. And it is helping in economic development and employment generation, as I already told you. So these are some of the benefits this Mitti Cool refrigerator is providing, right? And now let's come back to the question. The correct answer guys to this question will be option A, Mitti Cool, right? Mitti Cool refrigerator is the name of the refrigerator for which a new Indian standard has been developed by BIS, right? And let's move ahead to question number 2 now. This we have discussed in PIB 247 sessions as well. But this is again important for ERD current affairs also. और इसमें हमने कुछ और facts भी include करे हैं जो कि हमने PIB में नहीं करे थे, right? Which state is the 36th state or UT to implement one nation one ration card scheme? Which state is that? So now this scheme one nation one ration card is fully implemented across the country because we have 36 states and UTs. कितने states और UTs हमारे देश में? 36 states और UTs हैं. And Assam is the last state. Assam is has become the 36th state or UT among all the states and UT to implement the one nation one ration card in the state, right? And with this, the one nation one ration card is 100% implemented across the nation, right? Now talking more about this scheme, since its inception in August 2019, about 71 crore portable transactions have taken place and about 64 crore portable transactions were recorded during COVID-19 period itself. And there is an app which is used for its effective implementation, and the name of this app, guys, is Mera Ration App. The name of the app is what? Mera Ration App. And currently this app is available in 13 languages. It is currently available in 13 languages, right? And talking about this scheme in brief, so this scheme is all about the food portability. Okay, for example, let's say there is a person who is living, there is a labor A who is living in Delhi, right? This person is living in Delhi and he is a registered, or you can say he is an eligible beneficiary under the National Food Security Act. And he is getting the subsidized food grains from the government under this act, right? Now this person A wants to move to Haryana, let's say. This person wants to move to Haryana. Then इससे पहले ये होता था कि इसका जो ये NFSA के अंडर राशन कार्ड राशन मिलता था वो कैंसिल हो जाता था बिकॉज ही इज रजिस्टर्ड इन दिल्ली, राइट? बट आफ्टर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ वन नेशन वन राशन कार्ड क्या होता है, दिस पर्सन कैन अवेल द बेनिफिट्स अंडर NFSA, कैन अवेल द सब्सिडाइज्ड फूड ग्रेन फ्रॉम एनी फेयर प्राइस शॉप अक्रॉस इंडिया. सो इवन इफ दिस पर्सन गोज टू तमिलनाडु, देश के किसी भी कोने में चला जाएगा अगर वो, so this person can avail the subsidized food grains from any fair price shop across India after the implementation of this particular scheme which is known as one nation one ration card. All right. Sorry. So therefore the correct answer is option B, Assam. Moving ahead to question number 3, which of the following industry bodies has organized agrochemicals conclave? Now this particular news we don't have to go into the details because that is not required. Remember, this was the 11th edition of agrochemicals conclave, which is this conclave is always organized by FICCI, which is Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry. And we are discussing about this because there was an address by the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and in his address he urged the private players to come and join hands with the government to reduce the use of fertilizers and pesticides in farmer, thereby making the farming organic, right? So that is why we have to discuss this, because there was an address of Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and of course it is a conclave related to agriculture, and that is why there is a need to discuss it, right? Remember, it was the 11th edition, and agar isme se question aayega, so that question will be this only, that which industry body has organized the 11th edition, or you can say directly the agrochemicals conclave. So it was FICCI. Option E is the correct answer, guys, to this question, FICCI. Moving ahead to question number 4, Minister of State in Food Processing Industry Mr. Prahlad Singh Patel has inaugurated the National Conference on Millets with the theme the future superfood for India. Which industry body organized the conference? Very very important question. I believe ki ye question aapke ARD current affair mein aana chahiye, right? So there was a national conference on millets and the theme was the future superfood for India. It was inaugurated by Mr. Prahlad Singh Patel, who is the Minister of State in Ministry of Food Processing Industry, right? The question is, which industry body has organized the conference? So remember, this conference has been organized by SOCHAM. It was organized by SOCHAM, and do remember it was a national conference on millets. And the objective behind organizing the conference is to discuss the opportunities and challenges in ensuring the food and nutritional security with a focus on millets, right, with a focus on millets, and the theme is already mentioned in the question, that is this food, future super food for India. Alright, now talking more about millets. So these are the major millet producing states in India, which are Haryana, UP, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, etc. ठीक है, ये सारा नाम याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, जस्ट चार पांच नेम याद कर लो, सो दैट अगर आपको किसी आंसर में लिखने की जरूरत पड़े सो यू कैन राइट राइट. देन इंडिया इज द फिफ्थ लार्जेस्ट एक्सपोर्टर ऑफ मिलेट्स ग्लोबली. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन टू रिमेंबर दिस. एंड ऑल्सो वी ऑल नो दैट द ईयर 2023 विल बी द इंटरनेशनल ईयर ऑफ मिलेट्स, एंड इट वॉज अनाउंस बाई यूनाइटेड नेशन ऑन द एफर्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया, एंड दिस ईयर विल क्रिएट वैल्यू जनरेशन एंड प्रमोशन ऑफ सस्टेनेबल प्रोडक्ट्स इन फूड चॉइसेस विद अ फोकस ऑन millets. All right, and now let's come back to the question then. Which industry body has organized it? It was ASSOCHAM. Option C is the correct answer, guys, to this question. I hope this is clear. Moving ahead to question number 5. Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying will launch one health pilot project in which two states it will be implemented in its initial phase. Again, very very important question, bahut important question hai ye. Theek hai, so this is a one health प्रोजेक्ट, ठीक है, जो कि पायलट प्रोजेक्ट के फॉर्म में लॉन्च किया है अभी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग ने, और इनिशियल फेज में इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड इन टू स्टेट्स. सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द नेम ऑफ दोज टू स्टेट्स, राइट. सो दिस इज द न्यूज, दैट्स इट, इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग विच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फिशरीज एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग विल लॉन्च, ये कल लॉन्च होगा, will launch one health pilot project in Bangalore, Karnataka. और कहां से launch होगा? From where it will launch? Bangalore, which is of course in Karnataka. Now what is this one health, by the way? So remember, it is an initiative to bring all the stakeholders from animal health, human health and environmental health. जितने भी stakeholders इन तीन areas में काम करते हैं उनको एक साथ लेके आना और एक combined approach में काम करना, so that तीनों एक दूसरे की health को disturb ना करें, right? So it is an initiative to bring stakeholders from animal, human, environment, health on a common platform to address the challenges through one health approach. Whatever are the challenges in the areas of human health, animal health and environmental health, all the challenges will be discussed or addressed through this one health approach, right? And that is the meaning of one health approach. I hope this is clear. And in the initial phase, the project will be implemented in Karnataka and Uttarakhand with collaborating partner as Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and CII, which is Confederation of Indian Industry, as the implementing partner. ठीक है, this is very very important, do remember this. All right, so that's it, and therefore the correct answer will be what? Karnataka and Uttarakhand. Option D is the correct answer, guys, to this question. I hope this is clear. And the last question for today, Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, of course, has inaugurated the National Seminar of Bihar Agriculture University. In which district of Bihar this university is located? Very direct and very easy question. So this university, guys, is located at a place which is known as Sabaur, right? And Sabaur is in Bhagalpur district of Bihar. Option D is the correct answer, and Bhagalpur is also known as the Silk City of Bihar. Silk City, yahan pe silk bahut zyada milta hai, right? So option D is the correct answer to this question. All right, and that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section, and if you want to have the PDF of this session, join the Telegram channel. All right, thank you so much, goodbye, take care, and God bless.